A little bit of this.
I did try to do this for a dinner party. And it was a success.
This has become your swan's head, so you need to keep
it. I was going to eat that bit.
Can you video it?
I am videoing.
There's a really good, one online that Mike was just watching. And then, close to the core, they can cut straight down either side, but not all the way through. And then, line it up and cut it in again. So you meet the original one. You're going to make its wings. There's a lot of pressure. And then the other side, and try to get them roughly a little angle towards its head. And roughly same depth.
Who's going to be Rosemary Ford?
Got a lot now.
You've only got one
of them.
There's supposed to be a finger
ending
there.
Fingers.
There we go.
Two wings come out, and then you just keep repeating that same motion of taking little cuts down, and as many times as you can. The more fiddly you're feeling, or the longer you've got, the thinner you can make the cuts each time. You can go deeper and deeper and deeper, and then you make a nice little.
Oh, I don't. Poor Rick Farfish.
I'd love to see Bob.
What with the turnip?
Prize turnip.
We want to provide him with a sharp knife for you. You've got your Swiss Army knife.
That'll probably do it.
No pressure.
There we go. And then just keep taking sections and then you stagger them when you sit it back on all the way through. So we'll skip the doing all of the wings. And then for the head, you take a cut out of the bottom to make a point. And then it's going to be a swan's head. And then cut a little V in the top.
Well,
like,
you can't
correctly
say
that
you're never ever
going
to do this.
It gets much, much quicker. You get involved in the way you're supposed to do it. And then you've got a nice sharp point, and you've made that space. So it's one thing. And then you stack up the layers, and then put it swings. And then the more time, the further back you can go with them. So just keep making all the cuts.